What's up, Moda Brothers? It's Pizza Guardian, and today we're going to talk about a new topic called What If Stiles Strelinski Was Quicksilver? So, I'm taking Quicksilver from X-Men, not Marvel, because Marvel's Quicksilver is kind of trash. I mean, he didn't really get the time to shine, but X-Men's Quicksilver got the time to shine, and I kind of thought that he was overpowered rather than Quicksilver from the Marvel Universe. So, yeah, we are going to take Quicksilver from the X-Men universe or mutant universe, whatever you want to call it. But yeah, anyways, without any further ado, let's get watching. So before that, I just need to clarify some things. Number one, the story starts in season one where Peter bites Lydia. This is all gonna happen just before that, and there's a story before starting it, so I'll just quickly tell it. So Stiles' mother, Claudia Strelinski, was a mutant, and she didn't know that Stiles was also a mutant. She thought if Stiles would unlock his mutant powers, he would need help. There should be someone guiding him, like she had someone of a guidance when her mutant power was unlocked. But then she quickly realized that she couldn't help Stiles because she was on her deathbed right now. Stiles was near her, and she could only think of one thing: to sacrifice her life force to give Stiles what he wants. Not the superpower, but the information about the mutants. Stiles' mom, Claudia, was a magic mutant. She could use magic spells to, make magic fireballs, kind of stuff like that. So, and her great-grandmother was the same thing. So, she got this book, a spell, which gave the user about his power and what the mutants were, the basic information of it. So when Stiles would unlock his power, Stiles would get the information of what his power was, what the species he is or the bloodline he is. And yeah, so Stiles' mom used the last remaining force of life force and transferred the information to Stiles' brain, which made Stiles knocked out, and her mother died. So now let's continue. Lydia, run, said Stiles as he was running towards Peter, who was going to bite Lydia, well, for his own reasons. Stiles had things going through his mind, mostly about why the hell this situation was going to happen. Basically, he kind of blamed it on Jackson, but then he realized it was not Jackson's fault, because Jackson came from another place and Lydia went to another place, so it's not really Jackson's fault. But then he blamed Scott for, putting this whole supernatural thing in him. But then, he thought about it a little bit, and he understood that it was not Scott's fault that he got bitten. But then he realized that he was thinking fast. He never thought fast this much. Sure, he was smart and all, but he never thought fast. This thinking process was not this fast. He felt that the time was slowing down, and for him, it was. Stiles saw Peter just about to bite Lydia, and then everything went slow motion. Stiles ran up, then Stiles himself felt that he was running super fast, out of his control, and crashed into Peter, and then time resumed. And but it was too late. Lydia still got bitten. Stiles got up and couldn't understand what the hell happened, and even Peter was confused. So, but Stiles was angry that Peter, bit Lydia. So Stiles again ran at him and still crashed because he couldn't land his landing perfectly, which made Peter go, skid towards Lydia. And then when he got up, he saw Lydia near her and used this chance to get out his claws and nails and put it in Lydia's neck, which made Stiles stop in his tracks. "What are you?" says Peter in a more, because a kind of an interested tone. Stiles raised an eyebrow, saying, "What do you mean, what am I? I'm a human." So then Peter says, "You're not a human, you couldn't run that fast." Stiles was confused, but he didn't respond. Then he took a step, then Peter made his nails closer to Lydia's neck, saying, "Take one step forward and she dies." says Peter. Styles goes a step back and sits down, kinda, and he says, please leave her go, let her go, I'll do anything. Peter smiled at this because he wanted it. Then Peter said, call your friend and tell her to take her away. You come with me. And he took Styles and went. Styles called Jackson, who came to pick her, and Jackson took Lydia to the hospital while Styles went with Peter to do the whole where to find Derek thing. After getting the whole where to find Derek thing, his password being Scott's password being Allison and his username being Allison, he was gonna go, but sit on his jeep and go right to where Derek was, but he stopped, turned back and asked, you're not a human. I know that for certain. Your speed is quite remarkable. If you could train it, I bet you could become a big force. I would love to add you in my pack. But let's not talk about that, shall we? I'll go save Derek, then I'll add Scott to my pack, then I'll add you. So, peace out. He sat in his car and ride off. Styles just stood there thinking about what the hell happened, but then his head started paining. He got all the information that his mother gave him. Then he opened his eyes. A tear fell down, and he could only utter one word, Mom. Then Styles came back to the hospital where Chris, took him to the side and interrogated him about where Allison was. Styles just told that she would be where Derek was, and Chris, got the idea where Derek was, and he went with all his goons. Styles also went to go, but Jackson wanted to come with him, so Styles accepted it. While driving, Styles was thinking about what the Peter said and all the information he got a couple of minutes ago, and he wanted to try this. Okay, he got the basic information about how his mutant power works. So yeah, they reach Derek's house, and they see Allison and his her father down on the floor. Scott coming out, blasting out of the house. Then comes a mutant dog kind of creature, who's Peter, holding Derek in his neck. Derek in his hands. Derek by the neck. No, Derek in his hands by the neck. Styles got out and walked a little forward, telling Jackson to stay there. And Styles came on in front of Peter, and Peter just smiled. Well, is it about time you fought with me, Styles Stilinski? And Styles came to his usual sarcastic tone and asked, you really wanted to fight me that much? You know I don't know how to use my power, right? Says Styles. Then Peter just smiles and says, I don't think you... I know you know how to use your powers a little. Because if you didn't, you wouldn't have came here. Styles just smiles and says, well, I kind of know how to use it, but I don't have practice on how to use it. So I'll just use my training dummy, in a sarcastic tone. Peter realized, you are calling me a training dummy. Styles just nodded. Then Peter got angry and shouted, damn you. He throwed Derek a little further and ran towards Styles. But Styles was ready. He slowed time, ran towards Peter and punched him straight in the face, which sent Peter flying. Styles was shocked, okay? Styles was shocked. He didn't know that he could punch this hard. But then he realized speed, force, power. He realized that the more fast he ran, the more force he would create and the more power strength he would gain with the punch. Then he realized that he could just use his fingers to basically injure Peter, and he did that. So basically this was not a fight between Styles and Peter. It was just basically Styles learning to use his new powers against Peter, who was basically a rag doll right now. Scott was shocked. Allison and Chris and even Derek and even Jackson were shocked about what the hell was happening right now. After a couple of seconds of basically beating Peter to a pulp, Styles was just standing there, you know, smirking. Peter hated Styles kind of right now because Styles has whooped Peter's ass. So yeah, that's kind of bothering Peter right now. So then Peter got up and said, "Styles, Stalinski, if I get my hands on you, I'll tear you into shreds." Styles then sarcastically said, "If is a big word, you know that." This got Peter angry and he shouted, "Styles, Stalinski!" And he started running towards Styles. Styles just rolled his eyes and said, classic villain dialogue. "So if you want to do it, then I'll do it too." "Peter, hell!" And Styles just disappeared, and then Peter fell to the ground unconscious. And that was, well, the last we could see of Peter, because Derek got up and went to Peter's unconscious body and ripped his throat out. Scott was gonna protest, he's like, "No!" But he was too late, and Derek, slit his throat, and which made him the new Alpha. Then Derek asked one thing to Styles. "What was that?" Styles just raised his eyebrow and said, "Why the hell would I say that to you?" Derek growled because, Styles wasn't technically wrong and all, but anyways. Styles then walked up to Scott and picked him up because, well, Scott was still in the ground. Then he said, "Yo, how do you like my show?" Said Styles, and Scott just looked at him and asked, "What was that?" Styles looked around, people confused, basically Allison and Chris, but the most shocked was Jackson. Then Styles just winked at Scott and says, "I'll tell later." Then he went and picked up Allison, and then he went and picked up Chris, and he just said, "Well, let's go." And he just went to Scott, put his arm around his shoulder, and they both started walking to Jackson. And when they reached Jackson, he just said, "You're getting in the car or should we drive without you?" Jackson came out of full shock. He just nodded and went to his back seat, while Scott and Styles bent and just rode away. Allison and Chris were standing there, just not knowing what the hell happened. And Derek was just standing there, kind of angry because Styles didn't really say anything. So a couple of days later, Jackson comes wanting the bike even more than ever because he got the bike. And that's where season 1 comes to an end, and that's where we're gonna leave for this episode. If you guys like this video, like, share, subscribe, do the necessary stuff, and if you don't know, I can understand. I'll upload the next video next day or tomorrow, or day after tomorrow, whenever I will get the chance.